Gaayatri. At the time of creation, originally a sound was born in the heart of Brahma by the force of annihilation of thought waves, vritti nirodha. The sound became perceptible. Out of it, pranava, omkar, was created. It is called Veda Mata, the mother of the Vedas. It consists of three syllables, a, u, ma. Out of it all, the alphabets have come out. Then, out of the four faces of the Brahma, the four Vedas were delivered out. The rishis received the Vedas. They studied the Vedas. They taught the Vedas to their disciples. Veda Vyasa compiled the Vedas into four parts, and they were called separately as Rigveda, Yajurveda, Samaveda, and Atharva Veda. Having made the divisions, he taught them to his disciples, one Veda to each of them, Rigveda to Paila, Yajurveda to Vaishampayana, Samaveda to Jaimini, and Atharva Veda to Sumanta. These disciples taught their disciples the Veda in which they had mastery. Vaishampayana, the master of Yajurveda, had among his disciples Yajnavalkya, who was his own sister's son. Yajnavalkya was by birth a great yogi and of great intelligence. He was superior to all others in the class. Once he exhibited his superior intelligence in the class, and that brought forth anger in the mind of the master. Vaishampayana directed Yajnavalkya to vomit back all that he learnt in the class and be gone. Without a protest, Yajnavalkya vomited by the power of yoga what he had learnt and went away. The vomit was eaten by the deities of the Vedas in the form Titri birds, and that was henceforth called Taitreya portion of Yajurveda. Yajnavalkya was deeply pained by the treatment meted out to him by the master, but he did not slack behind. He performed great tapas in praise of the sun god with the aid of the Gayatri mantra. Sun god was much pleased with him and took the form of a horse and taught Yajurveda to Yajnavalkya. Yajnavalkya learnt from the sun god greater portions of the Veda than what he could have obtained from Vaishampayana. Yajnavalkya's prayer to sun god is an explanation to the sacred Gayatri mantra, which is of great interest and is reproduced here. Hail to the almighty sun god, denoted by the sacred syllable Om, dwelling as the very soul of the universe in the heart of multitudes of created beings of four varieties, from Brahma down to the stalk of grass, and outside as time revolving in the form of years, having an instant, a moment, and the twinkling of the eye as its subdivisions, yet unlimited by any conditions, like the sky. You maintain the progress of the world all alone, such as by absorbing water in summer and releasing it again as rain in winter. First foot of Gayatri. We duly and devoutly contemplate on what well-known orb of light, your venerable self, O jewel among gods, which is burning over there. O Father, which burns away all the sins and miseries as well as their seed of ignorance of those who wait upon you with prayers in the manner prescribed by the Vedas thrice a day. Second foot of Gayatri. As the inner controller of the multitudes of mobile and immobile creatures in this universe, which, as is well known, constitute your own bodies, you being their very self, you regulate their mind, senses, and prana, which are all of material origin. Third foot of Gayatri. Markandeya. Sage Mrikanda had a son called Markandeya. Markandeya had Upanayanam and was initiated into the sacred Gayatri by his father at a very early age. He began to study the Vedas from that young age. He was an ascetic by birth. He gained full knowledge of the self. He observed lifelong celibacy. He worshipped Srihari. He lived in a Gurukula of his own and performed tapas for many, many years and conquered death. Brahma, Rudra, as well as other gods were much pleased with him. Indra alone was jealous of him, fearing that he might have to lose his seat for him, and so sent many of his damsels to the ashramam of Markandeya. The peace of the ashramam was badly disturbed, but the sage took no notice of them. They returned with shame, and Indra's pride was put down. Pleased with the austerities of the sage, Srihari appeared before him as Nara and Narayana. Markandeya worshipped them both and praised them. The Lord asked the sage to receive a boon. Markandeya declined all boons but wanted to have a vision of his Maya. One day, while the sage was worshipping Srihari, a huge deluge enveloped the whole universe. The sage felt much frightened. Everything was enveloped in darkness. There was nothing but darkness. Amidst that darkness, there appeared a faint light and a banyan tree. On one leaf of the tree was a little baby of resplendent glow and beauty. The baby was catching its right leg with its hands and the toe was in its mouth. At the sight of the baby, the fear and fatigue of the sage disappeared. The sage entered into the body of the baby in the shape of a tiny mosquito. He saw the whole universe inside the belly of the baby, who was no other than Lord Vishnu. Next moment, the baby disappeared. The whole deluge receded. The sage was sitting in his hermitage conducting his worship. The sage realized that to be the power of the Yoga Maya of the Lord and sought his protection for the elimination of ego in him. Once Lord Shiva and Uma, being greatly pleased with the sage, met him at his ashramam. The sage worshipped them both. Uma was much pleased with the peace which the sage was able to maintain and spread. Lord Shiva said that the sage did not require any blessings as he had already attained the supreme state. He had merged with the indweller, the self. Anyhow, they offered him a boon. The sage replied, "Your darshan is the greatest boon that anyone can ask for. Now I have it. Yet I will ask. Please give me the unremitting devotion to Lord Vishnu, to his devotees and to your good selves." Lord Shiva and Uma blessed him accordingly with immunity from death and old age, with wisdom of the three kalas, past, present and future, self-knowledge, dispassion, the capacity to teach a Purana, Markandeya Purana, never failing celibacy and spiritual glow.